Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Today, let's see how you can create custom conveyors from scratch in RoboDK. Let's get started. For this example, let's open conveyor and let's bring in our conveyor.sld. So this is a very standard conveyor, to be honest. It's the one part of our online library, but here you just have the 3D model and nothing less. So I already talked or explained how to use the conveyor. So if you want to know more about how to use the conveyor, how to take the one from RoboDK's environment or online library, and bring it to RoboDK, I would recommend you to go watch video number 7 and 8 of module 4. So module 4, video 7 and 8, I'm explaining how to create a program, or to use, in fact, the conveyors for either continuous motion or for step-by-step motion. So it's not something that I will repeat here. I will just show you how you can create a conveyor from scratch. Okay, cool. So now we have our conveyor. I'm just going to rename it conveyor. Click OK. To create a conveyor, it's pretty simple. Once again, it's pretty much just a linear axis. So you can go to utilities, model mechanisms and robot, and here you have your linear axis. So in this case here, let's call it conveyor, and we need to create a frame. So in this case, I'm just going to create a frame and I'm going to reset it so that it's right here at the starting position. That's perfect like that, as you can see. Cool, it will be moving in the right direction, so along the x-axis, as I mentioned in the first video regarding linear axis. I can select my frame, so frame 1, or I can rename it, in fact, frame base. That would be a bit more consistent with what I showed you so far. In this case, there will be a base, so conveyor, and here there won't be anything for the joint. So it's kind of the other way as what I showed you for the pillar midsection, where there was no base and just a moving part. In this case, there is no moving part from the conveyor. The moving parts will be the objects we will drop on top of the conveyor. So it's a bit slightly different. So in this case, I will go for very high limits. So the goal is to have as much room to move as possible. So let's go for minus 500,000, and here let's go for 500,000 millimeters like that. Click update, and here we have a copy, so we can hide the original 3D models and frame. I can reset that to put it at the origin of the station, and honestly, I'm pretty sure everything is fine here. So I can reset again, sorry. And I can now move the TCP in either direction. So this is the tool center point of the conveyor. So if I was to bring in any type of object, so let's go for, I don't know, we have object inspection dot step here. If I click OK, it's here. If I put it part of the conveyor, if I move it in one direction or the other, it will move. Here, as you can see, when I dropped it directly on the conveyor, the object became a tool here if you look at the icon. That's clearly not what we want. This is kind of a small default of using, a mechanism as a linear axis. It thinks that it's a robot of some sort, but that's not a big thing to solve. The only thing you need to do is create a frame, drag and drop it on top of the conveyor. I'm gonna call it part, let's say. Just need to right click, reset its position so it's exactly where the conveyor tool is. From the conveyor, you can hide the tool frame, hide the frame, and hide the robot flange. You can hide here the conveyor base here. And if you bring the part on top of the inspection, on top of part, you can now move it in one direction or the other. So now you can move this object or many other object. But I already showed you kind of how this works. Like I said, go back to module 4 if you can't remember. That's very important. And apart from that, that's pretty much how you can create a conveyor, or some a standard linear conveyor. If you want to, if you need to go a bit crazier and you need to create a conveyor with a turning section or something like that, you can open here the curved conveyor .rdk, and if you run the main here, you will see that it brings, every time you run the main, it brings one part forward and it goes from a linear conveyor to a curved conveyor back to a linear conveyor. So I went too fast on this one. So, and if you click reset, everything goes back to its original position. So what we do in this case is we have one linear rail here, one linear mechanism here, one linear mechanism here, and a curved mechanism here. So we'll see how you can create turntables and other curved mechanism later. But here, by using a curved mechanism, if you see here, curved conveyor, and if you were to kind of show the frame, if you use it to, you move it around, you can see it kind of rotates like that. So you're kind of using a small Python, a macro Python. I will recommend you to go take a look. We won't discuss that now as it's not part of what the basic mechanism module, but we will undoubtedly cover that in a more advanced video regarding API and the uses of API within simulation. But the point is here, once one object reaches a certain point, we switch it automatically in the background from one frame, which is the frame of the linear axis, to the frame of the rotative axis, and back to the frame of the linear axis when the time comes. So this way here, everything is kind of rotating around, so I can put that on loop, let's say. And it rotates. So that's a very cool example. I recommend you to take a look at it. I like it a lot. This is the work of one of my intern. Pretty happy with what he did, and I hope it will inspire you creating some interesting simulation using curved conveyor. I also have some of my students, because by the way, I'm also teaching at a university here in Montreal. I have one of my students, at some point they created kind of a chain, a loop, so there was some part coming on top and then the jig of the part was like going under the conveyor and then coming back the other way. So they were really able to create a complete loop with kind of two half circle, let's say rotative mechanism and two linear mechanism working in opposite directions. So the parts were really able to do the complete loop and it was working just fine. So it's something that is not, let's say, part of RoboDK, but it's completely possible to create it. This is part of the work that I like, being a bit creative with the tools we have to create more advanced feature and do stuff that RoboDK isn't supposed to be able to do. So that's kind of what I did with the pillar. It's not part of it. This is kind of what Olivier did with the curved conveyor. This is not supposed to be part of what RoboDK can do, but it still can do it. So I hope you liked it. In any case, have a great day, guys.